We're going to be doing 11.8. This one has two pages. Second page is a fluency practice. The first page, I'm going to start by explaining that one. The directions, back up. It's very similar to the page that we did in 11.6 where it said listen to your teacher or adult as tell an addition story problem. The difference in this one, it's putting the work on the child. It is asking the child to be able to do their own addition story. So a lot of times we get really silly stories like I picked two boogers and then I picked three more boogers. How many boogers did I pick in total? Personally, I don't care as long as they're doing the math. So when doing this one, again, it doesn't have to be drawing. It doesn't have to be writing. Doing it verbally is absolutely okay. It's the concept that's being pounded into their brain. As long as they're adding numbers together and they're able to tell you the number sentence, that's fine. So the child is the one who's coming up with it. And you can help them with, like, giving them some snacks and being like, well, why don't you pull out some pretzels and make a story. Tell me a story using these things. So anything that the child does that uses addition or even subtraction, where that's next unit, but, you know, we can get started with that if we want, is fine. So this one, the child is creating it. You can have them make three, you can have them make more, you can even do less as long as they are working on the concept and it's helping cement it in their brain. So maybe my mom had two bottles of nail polish and then my sister gave her two more bottles of nail polish. How many bottles of nail polish does she have in total? And so it's working on the ability to tell the story, to be able to tell the word problem. So like in this page from the previous work, it said there were five frogs on the log. Three more frogs hopped onto the log. How many frogs are there in all? So we're working on the concept of and total in all. You know, it has to make sense. So if it's let me write this one. 2 + 2 = 4. My sister has 5 gummy bears. And then a monster has 17 fingers. Does that make sense? No. So if we're going with gummy bears, we're going to keep in that same thing. My brother has 2 lollipops. How many pieces of candy do we have in all? That would be okay. But it can't be just 2 crazy pants. So that's this page. It's putting the story problem on the child's brain. And then the next one, fluency. They can use their fingers, that's fine. But by the going into first grade, typically, we're looking for it's just quick. Don't have to think. I just have these math facts memorized. So I don't have to think about it because I already know it in my brain. Thank you very much.